Good afternoon. Welcome to Trinity Episcopal Church and the first concert of the 42nd season of a Midday Musical Menu Luncheon Concerts, both of those in person and those joining us online. I'm John Deaver, Director of Music. For those joining us online, a copy of today's program can be found on Trinity's website, trinitycovington.org, under Music and then a Midday Musical Menu. If you missed any of the concerts from last season, they're available on Trinity's website with a button below today's program. For next month's concert on Wednesday, October 19th, I will be playing an organ recital. One of the pieces is for organ and piano and features our senior warden pianist, Rebecca Gensler. Please join us. Today, we welcome back the Seven Hills Baroque, who also began last season. Skylar Hansen is on Baroque violin, Joshua Bermudez on Baroque cello, and harpsichordist Michael Delfín. As a gentle reminder, please put your cell phone on mute, and please give a warm welcome to Seven Hills Baroque. We were most fortunate to be Trinity's guests a year ago about this time, and I'd like to extend our thanks, first of all, to you all for coming, and to John Deaver for having us back. The music you are hearing on today's program is from France, and has a particular flair that is very, very refined and elegant and energetic and zestful, as you will hear in the last piece. Seven Hills Baroque makes its mission to illuminate the music of the Baroque to audiences across the Cincinnati and Northern Kentucky area. We particularly try to highlight the music of Black, Indigenous, and people of color, and female composers as well. The music on today's program is not entirely focused on that, but if you come to other performances of ours, you will get to hear such pieces. You can find us online on Facebook at the moment, and very soon you'll be able to find us on a website where you can read more about us, about our work, about our concerts, how you can contribute to Baroque music in this region. The music we just heard by Bois Mortier is of particular interest because it features Baroque cello in a place of prominence in chamber music, which was not something done very much. Usually harpsichord and cello would play together, which you will hear in our last piece. And the last piece features a rip-roaring violin part. Okay, it's an idiom, I tried. I don't know if it applies to French music, but maybe we'll find out. And this piece in particular features one of our ensemble's newest members, Skylar Hansen. The piece I'm going to play for you now by Jean-Philippe Rameau is from a much larger set of pieces, and this gavotte and variations finishes the set. It's a tour de force for harpsichord.